It figures to be a wet one, but we'll have baseball for you on MLB Network nonetheless. Game one here in the month of May between the Cincinnati Reds and the Washington Nationals. It's going to be fun marveling at two of the best in the game, and it's next on MLB Network. Max Scherzer, the Missouri-born right-hander, gets the job of starting pitcher here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Max Scherzer. Hello, Chief. It's Max, and it's not Agent 99. This is one of the best pitchers in the game of baseball. Upper to mid-90s fastball, powerhouse slider, and a great changeup. If he brings his A game, it's lights out for the opposing team.
Nick Castellanos now. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. One and two now as that one's fouled off. And the pitch.
Ball two.
A high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But it bends just foul into the second deck. Spoils another one. And this is exactly what you're looking for out of your leadoff hitter. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. Low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Hey, this has been an epic at bat right here. I don't blame the pitcher for a little nibbling right there. Maybe get a swing and a miss. He didn't bite on that one, so now we go full count.
There's a swing and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning. In now for the Reds, Nick Senzel. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Had a good cut there, but he can't time the breaking ball. That evens us at 2-2. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Working the plate is Carl Dixon.
Hey, Dero, one of the things you have to be aware of as a hitter from Carl Dixon, he'll call that high strike.
Yeah, he will. So you better be on top of your game with two strikes, because if they elevate, good chance Carl Dixon's punching your ticket.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
To me, when it's raining, the approach at the plate has to change a little bit, especially if you're a guy that can run a little bit. Put the ball in play any way possible, especially on the ground. Making plays in the rain becomes exponentially tougher to do when it's wet. So these offenses really need to limit the strikeouts.
At the plate, Joey Votto. So, guys, these Nationals, as they interplay here tonight, they come in off a good victory last time out, but one that was just their second win in their last eight tries.
Yeah, Matty, we had a saying in Texas, hit or get left behind. And that's exactly what this team did in their last game. Scored a bunch of runs, but good approach at the plate, working the ball to all gaps, line to line. This team swung the bats well. I'm going to be looking for that again in this one.
And this will be fouled away. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. 1-2-3 go the Reds. And now the Nationals get their first opportunity. No score. Trevor Bauer, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
One of the things that jumps out if you look at that stat sheet, a very high whip coming into this start. One of the things he's going to have to do a much better job, keep traffic off the bases, keep the walks down, try to limit the amount of hits. He's had a rough go of that so far this year. Let's see if he can turn it around in this one.
Stepping up to the plate, Trey Turner. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And the Nationals get a man into scoring position. It's a leadoff double.
Man, I don't think he could have bisected those fielders any better if he tried. Drove that one into the alley for a gapper that'll bring him easily into second base.
And now for Washington, Adam Eaton. He brings a hit streak that currently sits at 6 games entering play. On, he pops it up. But this will land untouched. With runners in scoring position this season, Eaton is hitting just over the benchmark 300 plateau. Source of pride for him, I'm sure.
These are the stats the oppositions look at. Being great with
this ball's down, and that could bring in a run. And now it'll rattle up against the wall. He pulls into second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
Every manager and every pitcher in the league loves to play with an early lead, and they've got one here. Back-to-back doubles put them up by a run with the opportunity to stretch the lead here with another dangerous hitter set to step up.
To the plate now, Juan Soto. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
I don't blame the batter for pulling the trigger right there. Those fastballs light up your eyes, and you can occasionally do damage with them, but he wasn't able to catch up with that one.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Runner in scoring position at second with one away. And in steps the lefty power threat, Eric Thames. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. That could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Here now, the 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full. Waiting on deck is Howie Kendrick. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
So now to the plate, Howie Kendrick. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Number 44 is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. One for the Nationals on the RBI double. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now 1-0 Washington. Well, there is some weather in the area here in D.C. as we begin the second, and for more on that, here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, the weather forecasts I'm hearing down here point to a fairly significant threat of rain later in the ballgame. Of course, the grounds crew and umpires will work to get this one in without delay, but they also told me that they won't hesitate to halt the game to let the weather pass through if it's impacting the play on the field or, of course, putting the safety of the players at risk. For now, we'll have to wait and see how things develop.
Yeah, Heidi, thank you. And guys, certainly having a fresh bullpen ready for a game like this one will be an important step towards victory.
You hope not, but you knew it potentially could happen. You kind of read the grounds crew. If they were running and scattering in the dugouts and running towards the tarp, you kind of prepared yourself that this one was going to get shut down at some point. But you got to stay focused. That pitcher doesn't care. He's trying to take food off the table.
And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. In now, Mike Moustakas. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. One out, nobody on. Fastball just missed above the zone. Liner toward right center. That gets down and he's got himself a base hit. It was pretty obvious in live action that that ball was hit hard, and after analyzing it with our show track technology, we see that our eyes did not deceive us. 114 miles an hour was the exit velo, an impressive swing of the bat. Into the box now, Aristides Aquino. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Moustakas, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. All even now, 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Won't commit on the slider, good patience, and it's full 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Now the payoff pitch home. Gets him swinging. He struck him out.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
In now, Freddie Galvis. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2.
A good fastball above the belt is normally a pitch that batters love to take a rip at, but that one froze him.
A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And the recovery throw will be too late for the force at second, so that'll be scored an infield hit, and there are two on with two away now.
You know, D-Rose, sometimes one of your best friends or your own teammates right there. Good hustle from first base to beat that throw to second. And guess what? He bought his battery, made a knock.
Yeah, he definitely bought him a knock. You know what else he's going to buy him? He's going to buy him dinner on the road at some point, because that's some significant hustle right there. It was a nice play. The internal clock of the defender thought.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Red strand a couple. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Riding in now for the Nats, Kurt Suzuki. His numbers against Trevor Bauer. He's got 3 base hits in 16 tries. He's taken him deep once. The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Popped him up. Barnhart shading to his right makes the play, one away. Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. And guys, as we take a look at the Reds entering play here tonight, they come in trying to rebound after a loss that snapped a modest 3-game winning streak.
Quick turnaround after a short little homestand, Matty. 4-2, though. They played well, taking 4 out of the 6 games they had to in front of the home crowd. They walk into this environment on the road today, looking to set the tone for this road trip. I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
And a fastball misses there, ball four. At the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Runner at first here, one man out. And he fouls this one off. Two balls and two strikes, the count to Ryan Zimmerman. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Great spot on that 2-2 fastball. You can't place it on the inside corner any better than that. And as a hitter, there's just not a whole lot you can do with that unless you're looking for it and time it just right. Love seeing a guy that can work the inside with his fastball.
At the plate now, Max Scherzer hit down the line at first. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering. Liner towards second, but right there is the second baseman, and that will retire the side. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on MLB Network after this. Top of the third set to get underway. So here's the Reds pitcher, Trevor Bauer, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. And ooh, that strike zone's getting a little inconsistent now. It's 2-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away. So in just one turn through the lineup, that's already five strikeouts for him here in the contest. And we show you the Nationals leaders in that category. You can see he's right up there at the top of the list. Ready now for Cincinnati, Nicholas Castellanos. He flied out leading off the ball game. Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled off. Another 2-2 offering. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Slow roller down the third baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Digging in for his second at bat, Nick Senzel. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. and it's fouled away. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
Digging in now, Joey Votto, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Here's the 1-1 now to Votto. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. First and second now, one man out. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Eaton is there now, and he has it, two gone. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Ready with the 1-1. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. More in a moment on this Friday night. You're watching MLB Network.
We're back now as the Nationals ready to bat in the third inning. And as they do, it's a good time to discuss their offense, which has been a real source of pride for this club. They're currently near the top of the league in team batting average, so more often than not, they're going to give opposing pitchers a tough matchup. One player told me before the game they have a solid group of guys in this lineup, but that they also owe a lot of credit to the coaching staff for working tirelessly with them every day to get them ready and keep improving. Really seems to be a total team effort, guys.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Trey Turner, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
Nope.
2-1 to count to Trey Turner.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
And the 2-1. Looked like he got fooled on the speed there. 2-2. Line to the right side and a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning. Already two hits in the ball game as he's on base here in the home third, and as you see there, his total places him second on the Nationals in that category. Adam Eaton digging in next. Runner at first to start the inning. And Dan, when it comes to pitching in the rain, what changes?
I think the most difficult part, Matt, is the ball gets slippery. It's hard to keep your hands dry. And if you don't have a good feel in that grip, it's hard to control where you're going to throw the ball.
The 1-1. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
He's set. Here's the 2-2.
Full count, 3-2.
Gotta believe that runner from first is gonna be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are gonna be moving.
Now the payoff pitch home. Swing and a liner, but foul. A runner at first with no outs here. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Senzel's got it, and there's one gone. Now at the plate, Juan Soto. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Here's a look over to first. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Pitch out. Nothing doing. Now the 2-1. Turner's on his horse on his way to second. Pitch is a called strike. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. 4 strikeouts already, and that's out number 2.
That's his second strikeout of the game. I wouldn't be surprised if a coach finds him in the dugout and gives him a little talk about shortening up and putting the ball in play. Good things tend to happen when you do that in these kinds of conditions.
Standing in now, Eric Thames. In there, now the throw. Oh, and it's off target, and he'll be safe at third. Two outs here with a runner at third. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. New inning set to get underway. Coming to the plate now, Mike Moustakas. He reached on a single in his first try.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
Now, oh my, this ball is crushed. Look at it go. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot that time for Mike Moustakas. Number 10 for him on the year. And with it, the Reds have tied the ball game at 1.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, is not the end of the world.
Stepping in now, Aristides Aquino. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Really starting to pour now, and the forecast is not showing any signs of a break in the weather.
You know, one of the big issues is player safety, and right now this field is getting sloppy wet, Matt, and I don't know how much more rain this field can take.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Hit on the ground toward the left. A dive, and he knocks it down. And no chance at a recovery here, as despite a great effort that time, they won't get an out on the play.
Hey, guys, he doubled up on that breaking ball. The batter obviously timed the first one. Second one, he was not going to let go. Good wood on that one, able to drive it for a base hit.
So now to the plate, Freddy Galvis. One ball. And he pumps the fastball by him here, 1-2 now. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. swing and a hard liner to center field. And that's in there. Base hit. And as a result of that errant throw back in, he'll advance 90 feet here and move up from second to third. Into the box now, Tucker Barnhart. Out in front as this is pulled foul into the seats. And he misses with it, ball four. So that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Trevor Bauer, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. The 2-1.
Well, that's down.
You put yourself in a situation, you got to get yourself out of it. You got the pitcher at the plate, 2-0 count. You got to take your chances and throw something middle of the plate.
Strike taken up in the zone.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that from a pitcher of this quality. I'm sure he'd like to have that one back to take a swing at it.
And the payoff pitch. And a swing and a miss on a huge first out there as he sets him down swinging with the bases loaded.
Now, I know he struck out there, but for a pitcher, that's a pretty solid at bat. Anytime you can make an opposing pitcher out there work and throw quite a few more extra pitches, that's a quality AB in my book.
At the plate, Nicholas Castellanos. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
He's got a chance to ring up back-to-back K's here, and that would be huge in this situation.
The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Base hit into right center. The throw is wild, and it gets away. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third. It's now a 2-1 ball game. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. In now, Nick Senzel. Fouled away. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Two runs, six hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat and trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to hit that one.
To the plate now, Joey Votto. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
A strike away now from getting out of this mess. Sometimes pitching is all about minimizing, right? So keeping it to two runs across in the inning would be huge.
And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So they wind up with two in the inning, but it could have been a lot worse as they leave the bases loaded. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. Reds lead this one 2-1. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Here's Howie Kendrick. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Nearly got the inside, but ruled the ball. Yeah, the rain starting to intensify here. It's coming down a little heavier now. We'll see how much longer the umpires can wait.
Yeah, Matt, right now this doesn't look too good. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see the umpires come out and bring the ground crew out here. The infield around the mound and around the home plate area is really getting soaking wet. And I can't anticipate this going on very much longer.
Now to the plate, Kurt Suzuki, 0-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through. 1-1. Doesn't catch the outside corner, it's a ball. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. An even 2-2 count to the Nationals catcher. Hit on the ground to third. He's got it. On to first, and Suzuki's retired. Two away. So two are gone now in the Nationals' fourth, and that'll bring in the switch-hitting former All-Star as Drubal Cabrera. One and two.
The count is 1-2.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Nationals gone in order. They still trail it here 2-1. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. So now the Reds cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. He got under one and popped out his last time up. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Skied into straightaway right. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Boy, after that base knock right there, D-Roll, he extends his hitting streak to 7 games.
Yeah, and you can tell he's made some necessary adjustments at the plate. Anytime you're getting a knock every day of the week, you're doing things right. Keeping that front shoulder tucked, staying inside the ball, not trying to do too much.
That misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out.
When a guy homers off you early in the game, the last thing you want to do is challenge him and maybe have him do it again. He was a lot more careful with him there.
Roenis Elias will come on in relief now as he'll make his 10th appearance of the season. Aristides Aquino will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. two runs, seven hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. And he fouls this one off.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Now a swing and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule. And that's out number one. Standing in, Freddie Galvis. Last time through was a base hit.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
Fly ball out to right field. Thames is there. Two down. Two gone in the Cincinnati fifth. And next to bat will be Tucker Barnhart. Fifth inning. 2-1 our score. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone.
This ball gets down. Let's see if they try to score. And that's going to plate the runner from second, as this is now a 3-1 ball game.
Dan, you were one pitch away from getting out of this. Two outs, two strikes on the batter, and he's able to throw out a ribby knob.
Dero, it's hard to get more frustrated than that as a pitcher. You're one pitch away from getting out of a lot of traffic on the bases, getting into the inning, and next thing you know, you give up a two-out, two-strike base hit. Nothing more frustrating for a pitcher than to have that happen.
Stepping in now, Trevor Bauer. 1-2, the count of the Reds pitcher. Line drive to left, and this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner, and this one will bounce into the wall, and they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score. Throw to second, but he's in there as a run will score on the play as well.
Well, he was definitely not looking off speed on that pitch. I'll tell you, he had to be sitting on a fastball on that one because it's coming in hot, and he still manages to get out front of that and yank it for two bases.
So now to the plate, Nicholas Castellanos. Lifted in the air out to center field. Eaton is after it. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and two left. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Reds are on top, 4-1. Bottom of the inning now. Now at the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. First time up, he went down looking.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Doesn't offer it the circle change there, and it goes full 3-2.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. Starlin Castro will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now.
Man, this guy's in a good groove right now. Seven straight retired. He's locked in.
Bounce to first. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And they'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And in the bat is Trey Turner. Now the 1-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number two.
1-2.
Two out, nobody on. Ground ball, left side. And there's a base hit as that gets through into left.
Hey, not a bad way to start the new month, B-roll. How about after that single? That's his third hit of this game.
Oh, that has to make you feel good. You see that calendar flip, and you got three knocks in your back pocket.
In now is Adam Eaton. He's 1-for-2 with an RBI double back in the first inning of this one. One and two now to Adam Eaton. Hit in the air to center field. Center fielder on the run. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Nationals leave one. They trail it 4-1. Austin Voth takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Striding in, Nick Senzel, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire, ball two. Into the corner and slicing foul.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
It's been a rough night at the yard for him. That's three times he's gone down on strikes in this one. So they've really figured out how to attack this guy.
Into the box, Joey Votto. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Soto is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. So here's the cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Reds are down in order, but they lead it 4-1. Here now is Juan Soto, 0-for-2 with a couple of strikeouts for him so far. Bouncer to the left side, but that finds its way through for a base hit. He takes the turn and heads for second. Onto the shortstop, but thrown away. Onto the shortstop, but thrown away.
And this might be the kind of AB that gets him out of that slump. Smart hitting here, just going with the pitch, using the whole field instead of trying to do too much. The results speak for themselves.
Into the box now, Eric Thames. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. He's set, and the 2-2 pitch. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Yet another strikeout for him on the mound. And fellas, this has been one of his favorite victims tonight. That's the third time he sent him packing. So he's got him pretty well figured out. Not that the rest of this lineup has been much better.
In now, Howie Kendrick. And that misses, ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring in the catcher, Kurt Suzuki. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. So bases are loaded. Nowhere to put him with one away. And that'll bring in the switch-hitting former All-Star as Drubal Cabrera. 3-2 with the bases loaded. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball.
Boy, the Nationals could use a big hit right here. They really haven't been able to do much all game long. This would be a great time to get something going.
And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
And this inning is a perfect example of how quickly fortunes can change in this game. He was cruising along, hardly any trouble at all. Now he walks in a run and is still in the middle of a bases loaded mess. He's got some work to do to limit the damage.
Here comes the Red skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make the change here. That's going to be all for Trevor Bauer. So he'll depart, though you can't quite close the book on him yet. He's responsible for all three runners aboard. Lucas Sims is called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Ryan Zimmerman will be the first to meet him here, and he'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now. To two balls and two strikes now.
All right, no more hoping he's going to chase. It's 2-2 now. You've got to come up with the best pitch right here because this is definitely a strikeout situation.
Bases are loaded here, one man out. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Victor Robles will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Takes a big swing here, but this winds up a little tapper to the left of the mound. And they get the force at home. Whatever works as the side is retired. So one run, one hit, no errors, and three men left on base. We're through six full. Reds out in front, 4-2. Hunter Strickland is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Settling in now, Mike Moustakas. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two. Lined hard to the left side. Foul. Ball and two strikes. Here it is. Fouled off. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Looked to me like he had the right idea with the swing on that pitch, and he just didn't get the bat through the zone in time. The pitch was away. He let it get deep, maybe trying to take it the other way, but it got too deep and was by him by the time his barrel could get in the correct position.
To the plate now, Aristides Aquino. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Seventh inning here at the ballpark. 4-2 our score. Line toward the alley in left center. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one, but I think we could say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
At the plate now, Freddy Galvis. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with only one away.
I'm sure the manager is fine with that. He tried to entice him with that 3-2 pitch, but he didn't take the bait. First base was open, though, so he just needs to make a good pitch for a ground ball.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and next to bat will be Tucker Barnhart. Runners are at first and second with one away. And that misses 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Two balls and two strikes to the Reds catcher.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
The 2-2. And he popped him up. And this is going to work out for him. It's a base hit. Tack on another here as the runner scores from second.
Hey, Dero, that's a big RBI right there to stretch this lead to three. Takes a lot of pressure off your pitcher going into the bottom part of the inning.
Yeah, Dan, no doubt. As an offense, all you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that three-run cushion has to make you feel good.
Jesse Winker will get the call to pinch hit here, and he'll find he has a couple of runners aboard with only one out in the inning. First and second now, one man out. And he looks at one in there, 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. The 1-2.
I'm shocked he was even able to foul that one away. Now he's got to set his sights back over the heart of the plate and maybe be ready for something inside.
And it's fouled away.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
Count still at 1-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. Grounder down the line at third. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. On pitch number 10 is the one that finally does it as he strikes out after a long battle here.
Runner on first in a double play situation, so you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone, so I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
At the plate, Nicholas Castellanos. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Fouled away.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Into center field, line drive, base hit. One run will score easily. Here's the second runner around third. Safe at the plate. And the lead is now 7-2.
I mean, that had to feel good right there, Dan. That's his third RBI of the game and extends his team's lead. They might have this one locked up.
Well, I tell you, those are always big, those add-on insurance runs. Big RBI right there for a little bit more breathing room.
Ryan Harper will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign. Stepping in now, Nick Senzel. And a half-hearted attempt that time as he broke the plane of the plate. It's a ball and two strikes now. Three runs already home here. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. So three runs on three hits, no errors and a man left. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. Reds lead this one 7-2. Jose De Leon gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Last half of the seventh here, so the Nats lineup turns over and to the plate, Trey Turner trying to keep it going. A perfect 3-for-3 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Into the box, Adam Eaton. He flew out in his last at bat. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Number 44 is there, and he'll bring this one in. Juan Soto to the plate now. He came across to score after doubling in his last at bat.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
The 1-2. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Three up, three down for Washington. They're down 5. It's 7-2. Start of the eighth on its way, but first Heidi Watney standing by with this report.
Matt, I had a chance to talk about the state of the Reds offense with their manager between innings, and overall he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. He said they're facing pitching that's throwing a lot of strikes and that has forced them to hit from behind in the count more than they would like. However, they do have 6 hits coming out of counts that were in the pitcher's favor. So that's pretty strong evidence that these hitters are grinding out each and every at-bat, Matt.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Digging in once again, Joey Votto looking to change his fortunes here. 0-for-4 with 2 strikeouts so far in the game. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Soto comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. So one away here in the Reds' half of the eighth. And into the batter's box next, a guy who's developed into one of the big-time power hitters in the league, Eugenio Suarez. soft grounder left side. Turner gloves it. And a low throw to first that bounces as he can't hang on.
Well, you can't fault the effort by the first baseman there. He did his best to make the save, stretching to his backhand side. He just can't quite close the glove on it, so it'll go down as a throwing error.
Riding in once again, Mike Moustakas. And if you remember, I'm sure he does, he hit a round tripper back in the fourth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses for the second ball.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Soto is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. At the plate, Aristides Aquino. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
The 2-1. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Third home run for him on the year, as this is now a seven-run ball game.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Into the box, Freddie Galvis tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Outside and a full count, 3-2. Count is full. Here's the pitch. Now a slider here, but this will miss off the plate away, and it's ball four.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Digging in the switch hitter, Tucker Barnhart. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Two out with the man at first. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Soto is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. But the Reds do push across a couple on this two-run home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. It's the Reds 9 and the Nationals 2. So striding forward now, Eric Thames. He's batting cleanup but has been shut down so far at the plate, 0-for-3. The 1-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
He knows full well he's sitting on a hat trick right here. All he's trying to do is avoid the golden sombrero.
Swinging a soft liner. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Digging in, Howie Kendrick. It was a walk in his last trip. lofted in the air out toward right center. In there, a base hit. Running hard, he's digging for second.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Standing in now, Kurt Suzuki. 2-2. Line drive to left, and that's into the outfield for a one out hit, and this will get to the wall over near the 336 marker as he arrives at second without a play. As also on the play, a run comes across to score. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance, and he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
In now, Asdrubal Cabrera. That's lifted the other way out to left. Castellanos is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. Now at the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And a ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. A payoff pitch one more time. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Senzel makes the play, and the side is retired. One for the Nats on the Suzuki double. Ninth inning straight ahead. It's the Reds 9 and the Nationals 3. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Daniel Hudson will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Wilmer Defoe will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Mark Payton will try to get his club a little 9th inning insurance as he'll grab a bat to pinch hit, leading things off here. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the 9th.
Anytime you get rookies just breaking into the big leagues, you have to expect a certain amount of this. There aren't any easy at-bats at this level, and you really have to learn how to slow the game down in your head because everything feels like it's so much faster up here.
To the plate now, Nicholas Castellanos. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Let's go, Nat.
At the plate, Nick Senzel. Outside, 2-1. Two out, nobody on. Two-one pitch is a fastball swung on and missed. 2-2.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
And he strikes out again. And that's the 5th time he's punched out today. This has certainly not been his game. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Robert Stevenson gets the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief. Leading off the inning, Wilmer Defoe, and they'll need him to get something going here. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. Stevenson is a guy known for his lights out stuff. He tends to rack up strikeout numbers at a very high rate. However, he does at times get wild. Walks have come back to bite him on more than one occasion.
You know, it's not uncommon, Matty V, for a relief pitcher to come in with really good stuff. And it seems like he's either really hit miss. He'll rack up a lot of strikeouts, but if he's not quite on, he'll also rack up a lot of base on balls. And that can cause a pitching coach and a manager to really start to pull their hair out.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out.
Well, we've mentioned the conditions aren't ideal with the rain coming down, and that can make every play a little bit of an adventure. You really have to concentrate, and he did there to haul it down.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Trey Turner. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
The 2-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. One out, nobody on. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. Adam Eaton is on deck. He'll hit next. Now the 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed, strike three.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Stepping in now, Adam Eaton. Rolled slowly down the third baseline. Bases are empty here with two men out. Last strike now for the Nats. Hit back up the middle. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
Chalk up another multi-hit game for this guy. He is absolutely on fire. He's been on a nice hot streak as of late, and I don't see it ending anytime soon.
Into the box, Juan Soto. Hard hit ball to second, fielded by Moustakas. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Yeah, and in this game, you always try to find a way to be hopeful. They win the first game of a new month and are now looking to keep it rolling the rest of the way.
9-3, the final tally here in this one. The Cincinnati Reds took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Trevor Bauer gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Max Scherzer was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB Network. Good night, everybody.